Blackstone Publishing presents The Wildwater Walking Club, Back on Track by Claire Cook. This book is read by Tanya Eby. We are all just walking each other home. Ram Dass. Under the Boardwalk, Revisited. Oh, when the sun shines down and turns your hair into a poof, and your sneakers get so wet you wish they were waterproof. Under the Boardwalk, over hot sand and to the sea, walk in at the edge of the water, that's where we'll be. Under the Boardwalk, slathered in sunscreen. Under the Boardwalk, walking toward the dream. Under the Boardwalk, picking up the pace. Under the Boardwalk, making it a race. Under the Boardwalk, Boardwalk. Day 1. 198 steps. Lavender water. 2 cups distilled water. 2 ounces, 4 tablespoons, isopropyl alcohol or vodka. 15 drops lavender essential oil. Mix all ingredients and pour into a glass container you've sterilized by placing it in boiling water for 4 to 5 minutes. Fill a small spray bottle and shake before spritzing sheets and pillowcases to release tension and encourage calm. On the 1-year anniversary of the day I became redundant, I woke up between crisp white sheets I'd sprayed with a new batch of homemade lavender water before hanging them out to dry on my backyard clothesline. I took a moment to inhale the invigorating fragrance of fresh summer air mixed with the soothing caress of lavender. It's okay, I whispered to the dark blur of my ceiling. I still have 6 months of base pay and benefits left. I don't need to panic. Yet. As a positive affirmation designed to get my morning off on the right foot, even I knew it could use some work. Every day, in every way, I'm getting better all the time, I whispered. I gave the sheets another reassuring sniff. Amazing opportunities exist for me in every avenue of my life, I tried. Every little thing is going to be all right, I whisper sang in my best Bob Marley imitation. My best Bob Marley imitation wasn't much, so I lip-synced to an imaginary version of Bobby McFerrin's Don't Worry, Be Happy playing in my head. I'd completely forgotten I wasn't alone until Rick rolled over in my bed. I chose to see this not as proof of my lack of focus on our relationship, but as evidence that I was getting comfortable in said relationship. I wiped an index finger across the corners of my lips in case I was getting so comfortable that I'd inadvertently drooled in my sleep. I cupped the palm of one hand and blew into it to assess my level of morning breath. Hey, I whispered. A small screen glowed softly as he held his phone above us. I got ready to pull the sheets over my head in case just woke up selfies were a new thing. Rick swung both legs over the side of the bed and reached for his clothes. He put his phone down on the bedside table and pulled on his boxer briefs and jeans. Rick and I had met at a series of small group outplacement counseling classes offered by a company called Fresh Horizons that had been a part of our buyout packages. The classes had seemed helpful at the time, but I also had to admit that almost a year later, we were both still unemployed, or at least underemployed. Before we'd taken our respective buyouts, I'd been a senior manager of brand identity at Balancing Act Shoes. Rick had been some kind of IT ethical hacking wizard at a company that helped financial institutions, as well as the occasional political party, identify their website vulnerabilities. Because the word wizard had actually been in his official job title, I always pictured him sitting at his computer behind a red velvet curtain, shirtless and wearing a pointy white wizard hat with Senior Overlord of Ethical Hacking emblazoned across the brim in gold letters. It was sexy, in a geeky kind of way. You could say that Rick's and my former companies had unwittingly played Cupid and brought us together. Or because we'd both taken buyouts, you could say that maybe like really did attract like. But then again, you could also say that two people as messed up as we were right now had absolutely no business attempting a relationship until they got their rebound career paths figured out. A shadowy Rick slid into his flip-flops and yanked his t-shirt over his head. Hey, I said again. I was romantic like that. What's up? He didn't seem to hear me. Maybe he was sleepwalking, or at least sleep-dressing. Rick picked up his phone again and held it arm's distance away. He gazed at it as if it were some kind of magic orb, or as if someone really...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.